King Ahab went to meet Elijah. When he saw Elijah, he said to him, "Is that you, O troubler of Israel?" "I have not made trouble for Israel," Elijah replied, "but you and your father's family have. You have abandoned the Lord's commands and have followed the Baals. Now, summon the people from all over Israel to meet me on Mount Carmel. And bring the 450 prophets of Baal and the 400 prophets of Asherah who eat at Jezebel's table." So Ahab sent word throughout all Israel and assembled the prophets. Elijah went before the people and said, "How long will you waver between two opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him. But if Baal is God, follow him." But the people said nothing.
Within the sound of silence.
Then Elijah said to them, "I am the only one of the Lord's prophets left. But Baal has 450 prophets. Get two bulls for us."
"I like the way you move."
"Let Baal's prophets choose one for themselves, and let them cut it into pieces and put it on the wood, but not set fire to it. I will prepare the other bull and put it on the wood, but not set fire to it. Then you call on the name of your God, and I will call on the name of the Lord, the God who answers by fire. He is God." Then all the people said, "What you say is good."
A little less conversation, a little more action, please.
Elijah said to the prophets of Baal, "Choose one of the bulls and prepare it first, since there are so many of you. Call on the name of your God, but do not light the fire." So they took the bull and prepared it. Then they called on the name of Baal from morning till noon. "Baal, answer us," they shouted. But there was no response. No one answered, and they danced around the altar they had made. At noon, Elijah began to taunt them. "Shout louder," he said. "Surely he is a god. Maybe he is sleeping and must be awakened. Perhaps he's deep in thought, or travelling, or just busy." So they shouted louder and, as was their custom, slashed themselves with swords and spears.
"You cut me open and I keep bleeding, keep bleeding."
Midday passed, and they continued their frantic prophesying until the time for evening sacrifice. But there was no response. No one answered. No one paid attention. Then Elijah said to all the people, "Come here to me." Elijah took 12 stones, one for each of the tribes descended from Jacob, and he repaired the altar of the Lord. He dug a trench around it. Large enough to hold two seraphs of seed. He arranged the wood.
"But it's the season of the sticks." And
cut the bull into pieces and laid it on the wood. Then he said to them, "Fill four large jars with water and pour it on the offering and on the wood." "Do it again," he said, and they did it again. "Do it a third time," he ordered, and they did it a third time. The water ran down the altar and even filled the trench.
"The tide is high, but I'm holding on."
At the time of evening sacrifice, the prophet Elijah stepped forward and prayed, "Lord, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, Let it be known today that you are God in Israel, and that I am your servant, and have done all these things at your command. Answer me, Lord. Answer me so that the people will know that you are God, and that you are turning their hearts back again. Then the fire of the Lord fell, and burned up the sacrifice, the wood, the stones, and the soil, and also licked up the water in the trench. When all the people saw this, they fell prostrate and cried, "The Lord, He is God."
I have to praise you like I should.
The Lord, He is God. The Lord, He is God. Then Elijah commanded them, "Seize the prophets of Baal," which they did. And Elijah had them brought down to the Kishon Valley and slaughtered them there.
It's murder on the dance floor, but you'd better not kill the girl.
Elijah said to Ahab, "Go, eat and drink, for there is the sound of a heavy rain." So Ahab went off to eat and drink. But Elijah climbed to the top of Mount Carmel. Bent down to the ground and put his face between his knees. He told his servant, "Go and look toward the sea." So the servant went off and looked.
I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time.
"There's nothing there," he said. Seven times Elijah said, "Go back."
You really got me going. You got me so I don't know what I'm doing.
The seventh time, the servant reported, "A cloud as small as a man's hand is rising from the sea." So Elijah said, "Go and tell Ahab, hitch up your chariot and go down before the rain stops you." While the sky grew black with clouds, the wind rose, a heavy rain started falling. The power of the Lord came on Elijah, and tucking his cloak into his belt, he ran ahead of Ahab all the way to Jezreel.
Hit the road, Jack. Don't you come back now.